The point is, there is one intrinsic inherent oneness, but that becomes almost like some kind of mystical teaching, some type of faith thing, as long as we do not recognize it. The undivided state of oneness is like that mystical state that has not been personally experienced. Shiva knows itself. Why shall bother creating this diversity in the form of the world? Because in this diversity, Shiva experiences oneness in this physicality. Without the body, Shiva would be just one, but would not recognize his oneness. To recognize, we need to have this pre-given some type of sense consciousness. I recognize you, we met last time. Means there is already pre-given acquaintance and now, yeah, well, last year. So then there's some kind of past tense and then a re-experience. So this whole project following this Shaiva philosophy is not just knowing Shiva. It's a recognizing Shiva in the body. Because disembodied being feels its oneness but does not experience in the same way as the experienced yogis do while being in the body, being diverse, feel that oneness, experience that oneness. And that is the mission creation. So the following Shaiva philosophy, the purpose of creation itself is to allow these fragmented subjects to experience their unfragmented state, their wholeness. It was not needed to fragment in the very beginning then. But without that, it had no ego, no subjectivity, no otherness. And therefore there is no recognition. There's just a pure consciousness, but not recognition. Now we can recognize in such and so myriads of forms being my own expression. Thank you.